Welcome to my channel Maths Pursuit. Today under the topic statistics, let us see what exactly we have in the question. Now moving on to the question, it is given that the wickets taken by a bowler in 10 cricket matches are as follows. Find the mode of the data. Now let us see how we can solve this question. Moving on to solution. So guys, as per this question, it has been given like the wickets taken by bowler in 10 cricket matches. And they have given certain figures and they have asked us to find the mode of the data, and you could see that they have given 2 6 4 5 0 2 1 3 2 3. So this looks, the data looks like it is, the data is an ungrouped data. Okay, the and we very well know that to find out the mode of an ungrouped data, it is like the most repeated value. If we see something repeats more often, then that is our mode. So let us put this thing in a tabular form and see what exactly we are getting. So I can write number of wickets like this, number of wickets, wickets in one column, and in another column I can write number of occurrences. Okay, so let's see. And you could see like they have given like 2 6 4 5 0 2 1 3 2 3. So that means the lowest value is 0 and the highest value is 6. So let me put this one as 0 in a alpha, in a particular order, 0 ascending order. I can put 0 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, now let us see. Zero, how many the wickets taken by bowler, so how many wickets taken within zero. So zero is, zero comes only once, so I can write one, and one wicket comes on also one, so I can write also one against it. Two, against two we are getting three, because three times two is there in this data. So again against three I'm going to write two, because two times three comes. That means 2 times 3 comes here, and against 4 I am writing 1, against 5 I am writing 1, against 6 I am writing 1. That means what we got, so number of wickets, that means 3 wickets, like 2 wickets taken in 3 matches, so this is the highest number of occurrences, and 3 wickets taken in 2 matches. So highest number of occurrences here is 3, and the data against is 2. So we can write here the maximum, here the maximum number of occurrences is 3. Therefore we can say that the mode is 2. Therefore we can say that the mode is 2. Hope guys you understood this calculation, or this this is a very simple, just we need to understand like what is mode here for ungrouped data. Mode is nothing but the most repeated values that we get in an ungrouped data, we call it as a mode. So if you analyze the data for a ungrouped data, then you will see that here in our case, you will see that this comes 0 came once, 1 came once, 2 came 3 times, 3 came 2 times, 4 came once, 5 came once, 6 came once. So that means here the number of occurrences or the number of matches is 3, and the wickets taken is 2. Therefore, the mode is 2. Guys, if you still have any questions for particularly for this one, you can reach out to me in the comment section of this video. Definitely I will get back to you once I see your comments. Guys, if you really like my videos, please subscribe.
If you really like my videos, I would request you to kindly subscribe and also let your friends know. This will motivate me to create similar videos in the future. Thank you. Bye.